Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you for taking your time and joining us today with the webinar on productivity tools. Myself, Sivaram, working as application engineer with Conceptual Software Technologies. So I have been into SolidWorks community for the past 1 year, and I have been supporting customers in all post-sale related activities. For the next few minutes, I'll be walking you through some of the productivity tools with SolidWorks, which will be very beneficial for you and would increase your productivity and saves your time in your day-to-day design process. These are the topics that we are going to discuss in this session. These productivity tools come along with SolidWorks Professional and SolidWorks Premium packages. So as the name productivity tool suggests, this tool will increase your productivity in your day-to-day design process by automating some of the manual methods which you would have been using all these days. So let us dive into the session and see how these tools work. So the first tool is Design Checker. So Design Checker is an inbuilt tool with SolidWorks, which performs the drafting review on your design. So it checks the files such as SolidWorks drawings or assembly files, whether it meets the required criteria like design standards, for example, file size or material, etc. And it automates the drafting review and saves the time and reduces the error. So it also allows you to automatically correct all the failed instances and ensure that everything complies with the standard. So let me demonstrate the use of the Design Checker within the SolidWorks window. I have opened a simple SolidWorks drawing in my SolidWorks window. So first of all, I'm dimensioning it using the model dimensions and then arranging them using the auto arrange icon so that the drawing becomes more readable for me. So I'm going to do the design, I'm going to do the drafting check for this drawing by using the Design Checker, which can be accessed from the tools dropdown. So we can see some of the standard standards like ANSI, ISO, DIN-JIS standards, which are predefined within our SolidWorks window. So for now, I am using the ANSI standard and I'm going to check the document. So as you can see, it populates automatically the instances where the standards have not been met. So we can also expand each of the item to see where the standard has not been met. So I am clicking it so that it is actually ISO modified standard, but we preferred ANSI standard. So this is the deviation here. Likewise, we can see for all the deviations we can see. So we can also click on the correct selected, which corrects only the selected instance. That is, you can see it has been shaded out, which means that it has been corrected. We can also select auto correct all so that it corrects all the instances and make sure that all the deviations have been met and the ANSI standard is followed. So we can also create our own company specific standard from the Design Checker itself. It can be accessed from tools and by going through the build checks. So this is the interface where we are going to click on create our own standard. Like we have many options like dimensioning standard, arrow style, unit settings, node font, and many more. So as you can see, we can specify the arrow heads, the length and all we can specify, and then fonts, what font and bold or italic or font size and all we can specify, and we can save it as a standard so that it can be used in the future for doing the drafting review for us. So we saw how Design Checker makes our work easy by automating our process and saves us time and also ensures that our project completes within the time. So the next tool is Defeature tool. So this tool is basically used to simplify our model. So as you can see in the image, before it has many details and after that the number of details are reduced. It is used to simplify our model. So if we want to share our design to our customers or clients, but we don't want to share all the design details, then we can use this Defeature tool. This tool is used to simplify the model by removing the internal components or internal details of the model. So by doing so, we can save our intellectual design details and specification of our design, and we can also improve the large assembly performance. So the Defeature tool replaces our design with dumb solids so that it can be shared without revealing any intellectual information. So I'll show it within the SolidWorks window. So I have a simple subassembly which has many details in it, but when it comes to a large assembly like this, such details in a small subassembly will be it affects the performance, right? So that we can simplify this model using the Defeature tool. It can be accessed from the assembly tab and going to the Defeature. So there are basically two methods. I'm selecting the sellout method and going to the next window. So first of all, I will be selecting all the components which I would like to keep it as it is, that is without simplifying it. So I am the simplification method I am setting to none, and then clicking on the add group button. So it opens the model in the new window without simplifying it. Now I am going to select all the identical components that are basically cylindrical in nature. So I'm selecting everything that are cylindrical or circular in nature, and then click. Then I am selecting the simplification method to cylinder, and then clicking on the add group. So it replaces those models with the dumb cylinders, and now I will be selecting all the polygons. And we'll be setting the simplification method to polygon outline. It replaces those objects with the dumb polygons now. And I'm selecting the motor casing and then clicking on the tight fit outline. And I'm also giving orientation plane. I'm selecting the side of this motor and then clicking to add group. So it brings a dumb outline of the motor, which signifies the shape of the motor. So we can also save this file with reference to the original file as a separate file, so that it can be used to share to our customers or clients, or we can also use it in the large assemblies. So we can also see in the feature manager design tree that it does not contain any feature, and it is externally referenced to the original parent file. That is, if we make any change there, the change will be notified here. So we saw how the defeature tool improves the assembly performance and also saves our intellectual data from being shared by simplifying our model in a much quicker manner. So this tool will be very useful for those who work with large assemblies or share their models with everyone. The next tool is the feature paint. Feature paint is used to copy feature from one file to another. So for instance, you can select a boss extrude from one part and apply its parameters such as depth or end condition or draft angle or any option of that extrude to another boss extrude in a different part. So it is used when there are same features in both the files but with different parameters. So we can copy features like extrudes, depth, color, texture and optical parameters and all we can copy. So let me explain it with a simple example. So I have opened two simple rectangular cube, that is part 1 and part 2. So I'm going to demonstrate the use of feature paint here. I'm putting a simple hole, a counter bore hole in the first part, and I'm randomly positioning its position in the part at the four corners. I'm clicking OK, and then I'm going to the second part. I'm using the hole wizard, but this time I'm using the countersink hole and I'm positioning it randomly at the four corners this time. So we have two parts. In first part we have counter bore hole and in the second part we have countersink hole. So let me use the feature paint now. So it gets opened in the task pane. So it has options like copy features from. I am selecting the counter bore properties here and I'm going to the second part, and the paste properties too, I will be selecting the countersink hole. Now I'm clicking on the apply so that SolidWorks copies the features of the counter bore hole and paste at the countersink, so that in both the parts now we can see that counter bore is there. So by this way, SolidWorks helps us to copy features from one part to another without wasting our time for recreating the same feature in the another part also. So the next tool is the compare utility. So generally parts vary slightly in design that may result in a slight change in its geometry, right? So the compare document can be used in this case. It can be used to compare document properties, features, geometries, or even bill of materials. So this tool closely compares two documents that help to identify any mechanical issue that may occur due to the difference. So this tool can be extensively used to compare a modified design with the initial design. That is for to identify the difference between versions. So let me demonstrate it with a small example. So I have opened two bevel, spiral bevel gears. So which is one is version 2 and one is version 3. So we have upgraded and made some small changes to the version 3, but it may seem very similar to our eyesight, but there may be some differences in it. So it can be checked by the compare documents. So it can be accessed from the evaluate tab as well as from the tools drop down. Can tools compare and we can select the documents. So in the task pane, the compare document options gets opened. There are two options, that is a reference document and modified. I'm selecting the version 2 of the bevel gear in the reference document. And we can also browse for it. And in the modified document, I'll be selecting the version 3. So that those two will get compared. And items to compare, there are many options. From this, I will be selecting the features. So that to compare the what are the difference in the features with these two versions. So SOLIDWORKS compares these two files and it will generate a report for us. So it has generated a report for us. So in the version 2, we can see two circular patterns, circular pattern 1 and 2. And in the version 3, we can see circular pattern 1, 2 and the cut extrude feature. We can click on the individual tree, individual item to check what is the difference has been made. So I'm selecting the circular pattern 1. So it gets highlighted in the graphics window. So it actually signifies the change in position in the teeth position which we have used in circular pattern. And I'm clicking on the circular pattern 2. It identifies the internal teeth. And as you can see, it shows that in the version 2 there are 10 number of teeth and in the version 3 there are only 9. So this is the difference here. So there's also another feature, extrude cut here. So I'm selecting it. So we can see that there is a cut feature at the back side of the bevel gear. So we can rotate it and we can also notice that both the parts will get synchronously rotate if you rotate one to make the comparison more easier. So we can see a slot cut at the back side of the gear, so which has been done in the version 3. So likewise, this tool can be extensively used to compare the version of two parts to which gives you a detailed report of what are the small minor changes that has been made. So the next tool is find and modify tool. So it is a very powerful tool which allows you to find a category of feature and modify its parameter depending upon our search criteria. So this tool lets you to find a set of feature in a part that satisfied a specified parameter condition and allows you to edit them in batch mode. So this tool allows you to find the feature which belong to a specific type and which satisfies a specified parameter condition. So for example, if you find all this, you can find all the simple holes less than 10 mm in diameter in our design and then make changes or whatever we can do with it respectively. So it actually saves our time when it comes to searching features, especially when our design is very large one. So let me demonstrate with a small example within SOLIDWORKS. So this is a small extruded feature with the three chamfer features in it. So I'm going to use the find and modify tool, which can be accessed from the tools and find and modify. So it gets opened in the task pane. In the feature to match, we can select what feature that we are going to search. So we can interactively select it from the graphics area as well. So the category and feature automatically gets populated and we can select on the find now to find all the chamfer features that is present in the design. So we can also clear this and we can search by category as well. So we can select features and chamfers and find the same chamfer features are being displayed now. If we click on each item, it gets highlighted in the graphics window. So we can also suppress or unsuppress it from here as well. So we can also edit it from this pane, this window as well. So I'm scrolling down and I'm selecting the parameters. So you can see all the chamfer parameters like type of the chamfer, distance, angle, and the tangent propagation. All options that we find in the chamfer feature are present here. I'm changing its parameter and then selecting the modify selected. So it If I do so, it modifies only the selected chamfer feature. That is, you can see that the distance has been changed. Now I'm selecting the chamfer 2 and then modifying its parameter now. Changing to 10 mm. Then now I am going to select modify all. So what happens is, irrespective of which chamfer I selected, all the chamfers present in the design are being changed now. So by this way, this tool eases out our work by automating the process of searching and modifying the parameter of various features. So this tool will be very handy when it comes to large designs where there will be a number of features and we can't manually search and edit each feature. The next one is Simplify Utility tool. The Simplify Utility allows you to create simplified configuration of a part or assembly to perform analysis upon it. So this tool performs an internal calculation of insignificant volume based on the size of the part. So this insignificant volume which we find using this tool can be suppressed and can be saved as a derived configuration so that we can perform our simulation upon this derived configuration. So the features that we can simplify are chamfers, extrudes, fillets, or all the features can be suppressed by us. So it actually identifies the feature and insignificant volume which when suppressed will not cause any difference in the analysis, and it saves it in a derived configuration. It is actually used to improve the performance or reduce the calculation time for performing the simulation. So let me demonstrate within the SOLIDWORKS window. So I have opened a small wheel component with the simple fillet features and cut extrude features in it. So I would intend to perform simulation upon this model. So I'm going to the tools, find and modify, and we can find the simplify here as well. So I'm selecting the simplify so that simplify tab opens in the task pane. So we can select all the features, that is fillet, chamfer, holes, extrudes, evolves, everything can be selected. Or only holes or only extrudes can also be selected. I'm selecting everything for now, and I am setting the simplification factor to 0.20. So simplification factor is a factor which determines the range of the insignificant volume or the feature that can be suppressed by us in our design. And we also have two feature parameter and volume based. In feature parameter, it simplifies the feature by feature parameter, and volume based simplifies based on the volume present in the parts and assemblies. I am using the feature parameter and clicking the find now. So this time I am getting only one fillet. So this is the large fillet present there. So it can be suppressed or unsuppressed from here as well, so that we can perform simulation. Now I am unsuppressing it and I am going by the volume based method. Clicking the find now. So that now we can find additional one fillet and one cut extrude feature have been added to the list. So we can either simply suppress all this or any one. I'm suppressing everything, and we can also notice that it is being saved as a derived configuration of the actual part. So the default one is the original part, and the simplify one is the derived configuration that we got by using the simplify tool. So it becomes very useful for us while performing simulation. By only specifying the simplification factor, we can determine how much we want to suppress. The next tool is thickness analysis. Thickness analysis is used to determine the different thickness at each point on the part. It is used to determine the problematic area within our design, which will be too thin or too thick, which affects the manufacturability of the part. This tool helps us to assess the potential failure region, that is the region which falls beyond the lower thickness value. So it will be very helpful for modeling thin-walled plastic parts or casting, and it also aids in the design of casting, injection molding, and machine fixtures. So it calculates the thickness throughout the entire part and gives us a color gradient throughout the model based on the thickness. So let me explain it with a small demonstration. So this is a cast part, so which I'm going to manufacture. So before manufacturing, I would like to perform thickness analysis so that I can check the thickness at various spots to make sure that it is manufacturable. It can be accessed from the evaluate and the thickness analysis. So in the analysis parameter, we should specify the range of the range of the thickness value. Here I am specifying the lower limit of the thin region, that is 0.125 inches, and I'm also selecting the upper limit, which I'm specifying is 0.375 inches. That is, my thickness should only remain within this range. I'm selecting the treat corners as zero thickness, and then here's the thickness scale, which shows us the thickness at various places. I'm clicking on the calculate. So this thickness analysis calculates and shows the thickness at various parts based on the thickness scale specified at the left side of our screen. We can see that the wall thickness here is a little bit lower. It falls below my lower limit, and other regions are comparatively okay. We can also see that if we move the mouse on the model, it shows the thickness at the specific point. So I'm going to perform a redesign so as to increase the thickness. I'm editing this extruded boss sketch so that my thickness will be a little bit increased. So it is 0.14 inches. I'll be changing it to 0.16 inches. So now my model is a little bit more thicker than before. So now I'm going to run the thickness analysis again to check whether it's okay. I'm clicking on the calculate. So this time, the thickness zone is a little bit, but compared to before, it is okay for my design intent. So I'm leaving it as it is. So the remaining all it is okay. So just the thickness analysis helps us to analyze and optimize our design to avoid the failure in the manufacturing stage and reduces our time and cost. The next tool is geometry analysis. So it is used to identify the geometric entities in a part that could cause a potential problem in other applications like finite element analysis simulation and all. So this tool identifies sliver faces, small faces, short edges, knife edges and all. So sliver faces are faces with very high aspect ratio, and small faces are faces which are very small to calculate, and knife edges are edges in which the angle between two adjacent faces is very acute. So when a part with these kind of geometries are present, then it would take when we are meshing these kind of parts, then the mesh in the vicinity of these kind of geometries will be undesirably dense, which may cause low performance. These insignificant geometries cause trouble in meshing the model in FEA software, or if you use any CAM software for generating G-code and M-codes. So these can be analyzed using this tool. So let me demonstrate it with a small video. So this is a simple model in my SolidWorks window, some extruded feature and the chamfer features in it. So I'm going to run the geometry analysis upon this. So as we saw, there are short edges, small faces, sliver faces, sharp edges and all here. And there are also some default values here. I'm keeping it default and I'm running the calculation. So in this model, there aren't any issues with the model. So let me create some issue for the demonstration purpose. I'm exiting from here and I'm going to create a small fillet feature. I'm selecting this edge and giving the radius as 0.01 mm. So now I will run the thick geometry analysis again with the same parameters. We calculate, we can see now there are some errors in it. There are two short edges. We can also click each of the entities so that it gets zoomed to it shows in the graphics window. We can also zoom it to see where it is. So it is the edge of the fillet. There is also one sliver face. You can click it to view it in the graphics window. So it is the face of the fillet. There are also two knife edges. So it is, we can zoom to selection to see where it is. So it is in the edge of the fillet. So these kind of feature, it is actually very insignificant when compared to a design, but these small features will cause potential problems when we are going to mesh them in FEA softwares, or when we are going to use them in any CAM softwares. So we can either remove it or edit it based upon our design intent. The symmetry check, this tool is used to it is used to check the symmetricity of a part with respect to a specified plane. We can also specify the color indicators for the symmetric faces for visual identification of the symmetric parts. It gives you an insight about your design, whether it is symmetric or not, so that you can redesign it as per your design intent. So it is so this tool will come handy in those situations for us to cross verify our design to ensure its symmetricity. So I'll open my SOLIDWORKS window now. So this is a small surfing board model. So this may seem symmetric for visually, but let us check it with the symmetric check. So I am selecting the symmetricity plane. I'm selecting the right plane for this model. We can also see that there are color coding for unique symmetric and asymmetric faces. We can also edit them. I am leaving it as it is for now, and I'm checking it. So SOLIDWORKS calculates the symmetricity of the model and indicates our model with various color coding at different regions. We can also select each symmetric or asymmetric faces so that it gets highlighted in the graphics window. So initially our model was found to be symmetric, but actually it isn't perfectly symmetric. So there are some errors in it. So we can also edit it based on our design intent. So it is always advisable to use the mirror command if you want your model to be symmetric about a specific plane. The power select allows you to select entities in a part that meets certain criteria. So if you manually select edges, faces or vertices or a group of those, it would probably take a long time for you, or you would miss some entities from selecting. So it will be more frustrating when we hold the control key and select all the features, and if we suddenly leave control key, then all our selection will go away, right? So this power select can be used to overcome such difficulties. So I have opened a small model knuckle part within my SOLIDWORKS window. I'll be using the power select in this tool, which can be accessed from the tools drop down, tools power select. So it gets open in the task pane. So it first asks what to select, that is from edges, loops, features and faces. And also there are many filter parameters. I'm selecting the feature type here because I'm going to select the feature, and I am selecting the fillets, chamfers, holes, and the features that are present in my model. I'm selecting the search so that it gets highlighted. I'm closing the command, but we can still see that my selections are still present. We can also unselect by clicking on the control key. So the others are still in my selection. So we can suppress them or whatever we can do. I am suppressing in this model so that I can perform simulation upon it. So as we saw how to use the power select and how it saves us a lot of time and really makes our work easy by performing group selection of entities that meet certain criteria and allows us to modify them very quickly. So let us summarize the points that we discussed in this presentation. So these are the benefits that we get from these productivity tools. The first one, the design checker, it automates the process of drafting review by checking the documents with the standard documents and make sure that all the standards are being followed in our design project. Next, the defeature tool simplifies our model and replaces it with the dumb solid in order to improve the large assembly performance, and also it is used to save our intellectual details from being revealed. The feature paint is used to copy feature from one part or assembly file to another file, which eliminates the need of recreation of the same feature in the other file. Next one, the compare utility. So it is used to compare two similar documents and it also highlights us the even the minor differences that is used, that is for version and all, we can version what upgradations that we were made in different version and all, we can identify using the compare documents. The find and modify tool is used to find a specific feature based on our search criteria, and it also allows us to either suppress or edit or whatever operation we intend to perform on it. The simplify utility is used to simplify our model by eliminating the insignificant feature or volume in it depending upon the value specified by us. The thickness analysis tool shows us the region which fall below and above the thickness range specified by us. Thus, it allows us to make any design changes wherever possible. The geometry analysis tool is used to identify the problematic entities like short edges or sliver faces that can cause potential problems while meshing them in FEA software or using them in any CAM softwares. Next one, the symmetric check is used to check and ensure that our model is perfectly symmetric about the plane that we specify. It also shows the symmetric and asymmetric faces with color coding. The power select tool becomes handy when it comes to selecting different features in our SOLIDWORKS file. It can also be used for multi-selection purpose. With this, I would like to end this session. Hope the session was useful and informative. So if you have any queries or any suggestions, you can always contact me through the mail ID and the phone number specified. So we can also provide you more information through web session if you are interested. So thank you everyone for your patience and listening to us. Thank you.